Welcome. I'm going to demonstrate using SynthEyes with the 3D compositing capabilities of After Effects. So I'm just starting by opening up a shot. It's a 16:9 shot. And I'm going to start up the auto tracker on it. So we're going to take this shot into After Effects, and we're going to burn a logo into the grass here. And we're doing this as a 3D effect using the 3D compositing capabilities. It's also might be possible to set things up to do it as a four-corner pin within After Effects as well. SynthEyes has gone and analyzed the shot and set up some 2D trackers here. Right now it's going and scanning through the shot and looking for exactly where the camera went and where all those particular features are located. We're just about coming up on that, and here we go. We've got everything locked up nicely. And now we're going to do something just to make life easier later in After Effects. We're going to go and create a couple of trackers right in particular places that are right at ground level. And that's going to let us just drop our artwork in After Effects a lot easier. It's easier to position and align things here in SynthEyes instead. So we're just going to fire up these tracks right now. It's working its way through. So these are supervised tracks rather than automatic ones. And the advantage is we can put them right where we want them. You know, the other tracks will be up in the trees and, you know, up on houses and stuff. So it's often handy to just create a couple that are things that are interesting to nail down exactly where they are in the scene as well. So that's wrapped up. I'm going to just go by and we'll just select these back again, and we're going to lock them up. Now we're going to also go over and we're about to set up the coordinate system, but just before we do that, we're going to turn off the exportable bit for all these other trackers, and we're only going to be sending these three to After Effects. So now we're going to set up and say we want this one here to be the origin of the coordinate system. We're going to put this one out along the x-axis. And this other one, it's going to be on the ground plane. So now it's just going to go and jump and spin everything back into place. So, you know, now that those particular three are right on the ground plane. And the camera is flying overhead and the helicopter, as one would expect. So at this point, we are ready to export to After Effects, and we're just going to save that away, and we'll just use the default settings, and off to After Effects. Okay, here we are in After Effects. We're ready to go and open up the exported file from SynthEyes. Is a Maya type file. So we have to import it. And once we do, we wind up with a couple of different compositions. We'll double click this one and it has the trackers in it. And it actually has the camera path animation and so on ready to go. Now we need to import also the original footage. So let's bring that in. And you notice that it is not at the right aspect ratio yet. So you need to change the interpretation of that inside After Effects. And it's actually at 24 frames per second also. So it's important to get that right and the pixel aspect ratio right so that we get the right thing. And once we have those adjusted, we can bring this layer in. And now we've got our trackers locked into the scene and matching up just like in SynthEyes. Now, one thing that you'll see in this is that the positioning of the trackers is different in After Effects. It's actually the corner here of the feature that's significant. So that's different than SynthEyes. It's not a big deal, just as long as you know that's what's happening. You can adjust it inside After Effects, but it's not really worth the trouble. So now we have our scene ready to go, and we're going to bring in another little piece of artwork here that I made up in Illustrator and Photoshop. It's got an alpha channel here. And let's just bring that down into the scene also. And then we're going to burn this into the grass. So let's change that into a 3D layer as well inside After Effects. And now it's kind of disappeared because it's off at a place where we can't see it. So what we're going to do is go and adjust the positioning of this layer. And actually inside of SynthEyes earlier, I just checked and found the right coordinates to use out here. We could have put a little point here from SynthEyes if we want it also. But we'll put that out there. And we need to adjust the sizing. So let's make it a more reasonable size. Okay, and now it's kind of sticking up out of the ground. So you could use the After Effects rotation tool to go and rotate it down more in the right direction, like this. But let's check. We need to get it really right onto the grass. So we'll come and look at the orientation. So it's actually 270 degrees. It's the right multiple of 90 degrees. We'll put it right on the ground. Now if you look, we've got it locked onto the grass. So at this point, you know, we can go and add some effects to this to, you know, adjust the levels here so it looks a little more realistic. But then we're ready to render. So at this point, we're going to wrap up the tutorial, but the final render is available on the website to look at also. Thanks a lot.